There are some legitimate questions being asked about how long our society can continue on its current path. I think there's broad agreement that we have to change, that change is inevitable and necessary, and how that change occurs and how abrupt it occurs is in our power to influence today.
PIRE stands for Partnerships in International Research and Education. So part of the desire of the National Science Foundation was to facilitate the building of new research relationships and education-based relationships.
We are a team of over 100 scientists and students from 6 countries across the Americas, Brazil, Argentina, Mexico, Canada, United States, and Uruguay. We study the impacts of forest-related bioenergy across the Americas.
Boom and bust social impacts. The idea of biofuels is to give society an alternative to that, but we want it to be an alternative that is sustainable in this period of transition that's probably going to be a long-term period.
So we study the soil, we study water, we study nutrient cycling, we study species, we study how these are all going to change as we focus on developing bioenergy in a form of either biomass, such as heating wood for steam, the power generators, or biodiesel. So we develop a liquid fuel now from a plant-based source such as palm oil. We want to understand how that's going to impact the social and ecological communities.
We are studying what these effects can be and how to improve the benefits and mitigate the negative impact of palm oil.
Basically, there's 3 pillars of sustainability: environmental, you have the economic, and you have the social.
We have to have people on the team who understand all those pieces. So we need social scientists who understand the people. We need engineers who understand the production processes, and we need natural scientists who understand the ecosystems and how they're being impacted.
Part of our job is to assess the social and ecological impact of bioenergy development. What does that look like? And we want to understand that from a unified framework. So we work to understand how communities, people, towns, employees, companies, and also the environmental aspect of that.
Specifically, there's a big controversy too on, and a great discussion on the impact on the hydrologic cycle and its, you know, potential consequences there. And that's what we are exploring with in detail.
Well, any time we change the land use and the vegetation that's growing on the land, such has been proposed for bioenergy development, is going to affect the hydrologic cycle. So fundamentally, we're just trying to get a better understanding of the movement of water through these bioenergy systems and how it affects water resources and water scarcity at the watershed scale.
One of the goals of PIRE is to estimate water use of different bioenergy crops. And here in Tabasco, Mexico, is palm. Knowing water use at the tree level can benefit not just local farmers, but also land managers and even policymakers.
Policy and governance mechanisms are often both the driver of bioenergy development and one of the most important mediators of the impacts of bioenergy. And we want to look at how policies that are proposed or passed at the higher levels are actually implemented at the local level.
It's been amazing working with this huge interdisciplinary and international team, because this is the only way that you can truly tackle these global sustainability problems.
It's been really helpful for my work to learn about Argentina and Brazil and Mexico and Canada, both so I can bring that knowledge home and so I can understand how sustainability fits in a global context.
It's just a matter of working together, you know, despite the challenges of the different language and the different culture and the different obstacles, you still manage to figure out how to do amazing research together.
So I think one of the very important outcomes to this PIRE project in general has been to teach us how large these problems are on the ground in multiple countries, how many people may be affected by problems like climate change, and informing others how to do that work so that the network grows and gets bigger, and maybe the problem gets smaller in a sense because we come up with bigger and better solutions in the future.
As you know, Mayas was one of the powerful civilization in Southeast Mexico, and I think Mayas give us a good example of what sustainability means.
When you look at how we're managing land, when we look at how we're using up our non-fossil resources, it's legitimate to ask, will we last as long as the Maya? Will our society in the new world be able to survive productively for 1,400 years? Or will we have to make a major adjustment as the Mayans did?